Children, it is a continuation of the science model question paper second, the continuation of the physics part 13th question, which is a 5 marks question. So what is that question? Explain Faraday's experiment of magnet and coil. What factors can be observed when the magnet is replaced by a coil carrying current? What are the conclusions that can be drawn by you from these experiments? State electromagnetic induction with the help of this experiment. See here, in this question, there are 4 sub-questions. First one is up to this, that is explain Faraday's experiment of magnet and coil. And the second, what factors can be observed when the magnet is replaced by a coil carrying current. And the third one is, what are the conclusions that can be drawn by you from these experiments? And fourth, state electromagnetic induction with the help of this experiment. So first part, let us discuss here Faraday's experiment of magnet and coil. Here you explain with this figure. Here take a coil of wire having large number of turns. It is a coil having large number of turns, and connect the ends of the wires. Here the wires are wounded and turns of wires are there. Connect the two ends of the wire to a galvanometer. Move the north pole of strong magnet towards the end of coil. Here is a magnet. Move its north pole towards the end B of this coil. There is a momentary deflection in the needle of galvanometer. Observe the deflection in the galvanometer. Galvanometer shows the deflection. The indicator in the galvanometer shows the deflection. So the needle of the galvanometer shows the deflection. There is a momentary deflection in the needle of galvanometer. This indicates the presence of current in the coil AB. What does this indicate? This indicates the presence of electric current in the coil. Next, you replace the north pole and move the south pole towards the end B of the coil. If south pole of the magnet is moved towards the end of the end B of the coil, the deflection in the galvanometer would be opposite to the previous case. Yeah, I replace in the north pole, move the south pole towards the end B. Move the south pole towards the end B of the coil, then also there is a deflection in the galvanometer, but the deflection is in the opposite direction. So the deflection in the galvanometer would be opposite to the previous case. The next stage, keep the magnet stationary, move the coil towards magnet. Keeping magnet stationary, move the coil towards the magnet. Then also the galvanometer shows deflections, and that is towards one direction, that is towards left. When the coil moves away from the magnet, the deflection is in the deflection in the galvanometer is in opposite direction. In the first case, magnet north pole is moved, then the galvanometer shows deflection in one direction. When the south pole is moved, then also there is a deflection. And the third step, keep the magnet stationary and move the coil towards it, then also there is a deflection. And when the coil moves away from the magnet, then also there is a deflection, but that is in the opposite direction. That is in the opposite direction. Here, in 4 cases, you observed the deflection in the galvanometer. In the first case, when the north pole moves towards the end B, then the deflection is in one direction. And when the south pole is moved towards the and B. Then also there is a deflection in the galvanometer, but in the opposite to the previous case. And keeping the magnet stationary, move the coil towards the magnet. Then also there is a deflection in the galvanometer in the left side. And when the coil moves away from the magnet, then also there is a deflection in the galvanometer, that is in the opposite direction. So here either the magnet moves, there is a deflection, or the coil moves, then also there is a deflection. When coil and magnet are kept stationary, there is no deflection in the galvanometer. If both magnet and coil are stationary, then there is no deflection in the galvanometer. So it is clear from this activity that motion of the magnet with respect to the coil produces potential difference, which sets up an induced electric current in the circuit. That is about the Faraday's experiment of magnet and the coil. Next, come to the next part. What factors can be observed when the magnet is replaced by a coil carrying current? When the magnet is replaced by a coil carrying current, here the coil 1 is the current carrying coil, which is replaced by the magnet. When the magnet is replaced by coil 1, which is a current carrying coil, it is having larger number of turns. Magnet is replaced by coil 1, which is a current carrying coil having larger number of turns. When the key is plugged in, here is a key which is plugged in, needle of the galvanometer which is connected to the coil 2. Here you know that the coil 2 is having a connection with the galvanometer. When the key is plugged in, the galvanometer of the second coil instantly jumps to one side and quickly returns to zero. Galvanometer, the needle of the galvanometer which is connected to the coil 2 jumps instantly to one side and quickly returns to zero. Disconnect the coil. Here you remove the key from the plug. Disconnect coil 1 means remove the key from the plug. We observe that needle moves in the opposite direction and returns to zero. Disconnect coil 1 from the battery, that is by removing the key from the plug. We observe that needle moves in opposite direction and returns to zero. So from these observations we conclude that potential difference is induced in the coil 2 whenever the electric current through the coil 1 is changing. Potential difference is induced in the coil 2 when the current in the coil 1 is changed. As the current in the first coil changes, magnetic field associated with it also changes. The magnetic field around coil 2 also changes and causes induced electric current in the second coil. So this is about the what factors can observe when the magnet is replaced by a coil carrying current, and also conclusion. What is that conclusion here? So for the third part, here the third part is, what are the conclusions that can be drawn by you from these experiments? So you write, from these observations we conclude that a potential difference is induced in the coil 2 whenever the electric current through the coil 1 is changing. As the current in the first coil changes, magnetic field associated with it also changes. the magnetic field around coil 2 also changes and causes induced electric current in the second coil. That is the observation. Then the fourth one, what is electromagnetic induction? Define electromagnetic induction. So, process by which changing magnetic field in a conductor induces a current in another conductor is called electromagnetic induction. Process by which changing magnetic field in a conductor induces a current in another conductor is called electromagnetic induction. So here the 5 mass question is completed. Here there are 4 sub questions. This is explain Faraday's experiment of magnet and coil. What factors can be observed when the magnet is replaced by a coil carrying current, and what are the conclusions that can be drawn by you from this experiment, and state electromagnetic induction with the help of this experiment. So this is about the answer to each part. So you got the answer for the 5 mass question.